Hi there, this is Eric at Loft and Art, and I got some fresh figs ripening. Well, we got some decent weather. We had a couple of days of rain, and now it's really hot and dry again. During the day, this is considered our Indian summer period, so you know, it's about 80 degrees today. Tonight it'll be down probably mid-40s. So the trees are constantly in a state of stress, and since we had rain for a couple of days straight, just not that long ago, I haven't been too inclined to water, and so, you know, some of them are tricking me into thinking that some of them are ripe, but we've also got a lot of bug pressure, and you know, it's just that time of year, unfortunately. So, you know, you see a lot of that going on with the, this is cucumber beetle issues. That's what they're doing to the figs. Unfortunately, I mean, there's no getting around it. So, what we have here are, this is Borda Barraquer. That is a Pons variety. This one is Col de Dame Blanca-Negra, grown in ground in Oregon. Yes, we can grow that one in the ground. This one is Del Vespro, no greenhouse, no head start. This one is Dan Manel. This is another Pons variety. These are both Pons varieties, Dan Manel and Col de Dame Blanca-Negra. And then this one here is Brown Sugar Crunch. And kind of interesting on this one this year, there's not a lot of brown sugar to it. I get a lot more berry. So we'll start here with the small one. This is Del Vespro. And not at all like what I thought it would be. And it does ripen. It's a ripening fig. It was bent over, but certainly doesn't look, like I thought it would. It's supposed to be like a dark pink on the inside, but that may have been a product of pollination, and that's the unfortunate part of some of this, right? So we'll give this one a shot. Oh, okay, so it's pleasantly sweet. I'm not willing to write that one off yet. That's much better than I thought it would be. Yeah, perfectly sweet. So that gives me a little hope. But it's ripening without a greenhouse, without any protection over the winter. It doesn't have any problem lignifying. It sets a lot of fruit, and certainly seems to be relatively early. We'll see if the interior color changes as the tree gets older. This is the first one off of the tree, so it is sweet though, and that's a really a big plus compared to some first year fruits that I've had. They're just not very good, to be honest with you. So this is encouraging. All right, there's not much to it, not from a complexity standpoint. It just tastes like a good sweet fig. Despite the color, I don't necessarily consider it a honey fig or anything, maybe a sugar fig. Not terribly complex, like I said, but very good. Surprisingly better than I thought it would be. So let's go with, that one looks pretty nice. That one looks pretty nice. This one is not as jammy as I would like. These are, and again, speaking of bug pressure, cucumber beetles. I just a scourge. So those look really nice. Let's see. Let's go with. We'll try this one next. All right. So this is Borda Barraquer. I got my tree from Will's. Well, my cutting from Will's. It is. I trust Will's. For the most part, sells what he says he's selling. It certainly looks the part. It's the right color. It's the right shape. We'll give it a shot and see what it tastes like. This one did get a greenhouse start, though. This is a late variety. I don't think there's any chance that this one ripens without a greenhouse here in Oregon. It doesn't look jammy, but my goodness, that's a good fig. I should have saved that one for the end. Tangy, very berry forward. Excellent, excellent fig. Very thick, meaty pulp. That's really good. I was worried when I cut it open that it wasn't all the way ripe or wasn't going to be ripe enough. Not true at all. That's excellent. That's a nice surprise. So first year fruiting for me. I have a small handful of late varieties that I want to keep. When I have a fruit like this, that makes things a lot harder. I want some of these late varieties to suck so I can get rid of them. That one is really, really nice. So, okay. All right, let's go with, well, I got more of these. Let's go with a brown sugar crunch. So this one's a little less ripe than the other. These have been more berry this year than brown sugar. But they do have a nice seed crunch. They're smaller in a pot. But my friend Chris down at his place in Cottage Grove on the lake, he gets much, much bigger fruit on his in-ground tree. That's something to consider because a lot of my trees are potted. So they're also water stressed. So I don't get super big fruit. Very nice fig. Tangy. Reminds me a little bit of almost a little bit of Floria. But yeah, I know it's not the same fig. But very sweet, a little tangy. This one is a little bit more ripe, so we'll see if this is any different. Definitely not brown sugar on that one. So maybe this one will be. No. That's actually a very nice berry fig. That one's really good. So this is also no greenhouse or head start. This is one that can for sure be grown in the ground in the Willamette Valley. It's been proven. So that's really great. All right. So let's go Den Manel next. This one got a greenhouse start. I also got a Breba off of this tree. So this has got some modicum of potential for possibly being able to be grown in the ground, but I don't know how productive the Breba crop is. The Breba was really promising. All right, so. Wow, very thick. It's got a similar texture of pulp to Planera. So it's very thick, very gelatinous. It's got a nice seed crunch. It's sweet. but it needs some more maturity. I can tell that. This is the first year it's fruited. A lot of first year fruits taste very similar. This has that same kind of unseasoned kind of flavor that a lot of first year trees have. This one did not. This one tastes like a phenomenally mature tree. So that's kind of interesting. That is, looks like maybe a bug bit into that one. But it's got promise. Now, I can't speak to whether or not this is the same as Gris de Saint-Jean. Some people say they are. I don't know. I have Gris de Saint-Jean and it hasn't ripened anything yet. And Den Manel is ripening. They both got the same amount of head start in the greenhouse. It could be tree-to-tree variation. It could be that they are slightly different. It could be any number of variables that factor in. I don't know. It is a good fig. I think it does have some potential for being grown in the ground based on the fact that it produced a Brepa. I think it may be too late to get main crop though. So take that for what you will. Now, one that can be grown in the ground that's not too late to get main crop is Col de Dama Blanca-Negra. And Harvey sells this variety. His source for it is the same source of mine. So, or where I got mine from, they originally got it from the same source that Harvey got his from. And it came directly from Pons, from that person. So, there are questions as to whether or not it's the true Col de Dama Blanca-Negra, because it has a hard time showing the characteristic, making some figs that are dark and some that are light. Mine does both, but the dark figs are not super dark. It's not like they're making a purple fig and a white fig on the same branch. I think it's based on the amount of sunlight that they are exposed to. I had another one earlier that was much darker than this. I have some on the tree that are much lighter than this. So, this was one of my top five varieties last year. So I'm excited to see that me claiming that I think it could ripen in the ground is actually paying dividends and is actually proving to be true. In a down year, by the first part of October, we're getting this fig in ground. So, oh man. Oh man. That is just so ridiculously good. This may be, I honestly think this may be one of the best figs we can grow on the ground. Super, super thick. Very, very sweet strawberry candy flavor. It does have a little bit of an open eye, but overall, this is a very, very high quality fig. Man alive. This one, honest to God, this one needs to be in a lot of people's hands around the Northwest. Even if you're not here in the Willamette Valley where, you know, I'm not going to lie, it gets pretty warm here. I think this one could do well in a variety of climates. My potted tree started ripening about the same time as the in-ground tree. Both with zero head start. Neither one getting greenhouse, ripening, starting to ripen by the end of September in a down year. In a good year, in a normal year, where we don't have a really cold spring that sets everything back, I think this is going to be ripening by mid-September once it's established. My goodness. What a fantastic fig. Okay. All right. I don't want to sound like I'm trying to hype anything out. I don't have any skin in that game. If I had to rate the stuff on the plate, this would be at the bottom. And these two would be neck and neck, followed by this one. Then this one. This is the best. Super thick, super dense, seed crunch, extremely sweet, strawberry candy flavor. This is a more intense berry flavor. It's a little bigger, but we know we can grow this one in the ground. So there you go. All right, take care. There's bound to be some more floating around out here in the yard. I gotta move my sprinklers and see what I can find. All right, see you on the next one.